this again.
Beautiful here, but I'm afraid my journey to the sanctuary might have been in vain. I've prayed to Amadia real hard, but I'm not sure it's done much good. Still, a wizard trapped in a pig's body. Any ideas? Oh, what a grand idea! I'll try that. What's the worst that could happen? Hello. May you walk with Amadia. I'm a wizard, and I was a long time ago, too. In between, I was a pig, and I was on fire for most of that time. It's a long story, but I think I'll leave it in the past and look to the future instead. Of course. Bye now.
Boring. Rubbish.
Removed your collar like a disobedient dog, I see. A very stout, very ugly dog. I'd pity you, but Shepra the Ineffable has no patience for weakness. Let your stumpy legs carry you away while they still can. Easy, Gecko, or I'll root you to the ground and call a Voidwoken to show you the true meaning of terror. Of course, precious. But which is worse, the cure or the disease? Sorcerers dance while magisters pull the strings. Fools all! Their tomfoolery won't save them from the destruction the void shall wreak upon them. This power is my birthright, same as yours, but one of us has grown to astounding heights and the other has sunk into depths too humiliating to describe. Pity. But of course, they'll happily dump your maggot-ridden corpse into the sea when they're through with you. Foolish divine order.
Goals, I guess.
You remember what I said. No sense in going at this whole mean world alone.
Oh, hey! Hey! I thought you might be Emmy. It's...
The dog cries a nervous, high-pitched whine.
When is she coming back? You don't know that. Sometimes people go away, even for a long time. They usually come back. I bet Emmy will too.
The dog wags his tail, hopefully.
Thank you. the dark with you.
A moment's pause. I had thought...
The frogs are gone. The children shall be safer. I see the good in you. I see all of you.
Got you! Oh, I got you!
Hugo, you survive the journey.
Soon I am quite
I see
well
it.
Again. Then we make
and
another.
Thank you.
Then we make another attempt.
Thank you.
girl?
It was her, wasn't it? The monster.
Don't think of the other now.
What's happened? What have they done to you?
Fine.
With you.
The princess will be delighted when she learns she's free once more.
Thank you.
my love, my print. There is much to prepare for our nuptials, and word still has to be spread throughout the land. Be on your way.
They'll come. Guards! There is no leaving. Don't you know what's outside the fort? I tried to leave. I heard of a shelter in the Hollow Marshes, a place where sorcerers could go. The undead had their hands on me in 5 minutes. Shredding, tearing. I came limping back and now... Help me! Help me! I'm not trying to escape, I swear! Make him leave! Take him away!
Look at you, all enthusiastic and everything.
Out of the frying pan and into...
Are you certain you want to dismiss your
If we have different paths to take, you and I, so be it.
Mama. You again? Can't you see I'm rather busy?
He lifts the corpse's eyelids, peering underneath.
It could be worse. Although they could certainly be better. I suppose, circumstances being what they are, you seem more at ease in this world than I. A guide would certainly be useful. Very well. Let's be off. Thank you.
May your every seedling bear it's easier than boiling an egg. Just place a seedling in a bucket and then place it in the ground. The plants know what to do from there. And so many plants can be grown in this way. Try Amaduvier, a puffball, Drudenay.
Too heavy.
It's been cursed. It's been cursed. It's been cursed. It's been cursed.
Ah, the armor set is complete.
The ring just got tighter. A lot tighter.
Something isn't right. The ring's gone, but not its curse. Ring. It's loose. Get off me and stay off.
in their right mind would think of a thing like this?
I must say, I was lacking skin may make me a target for mortals, but I am mercifully immune to mosquitoes. However, they are infuriating when they get in one's skull. I can barely hear myself think. I fell victim to the enemy of all great minds. Fear. Fear of the unknown, fear of change. These are the things that poison civilizations. I was on the cusp of a glorious breakthrough. But my king's fear held me back. I discovered a veil hanging across the universe, a barrier of pure source. It was amazing, the kind of discovery on which a civilization turns. Who knows what secrets may have been hidden behind that curtain? But my king forbade me from further investigation. Do you know? I never thought to ask. Between him purging me and casting me into a traitor's tomb. What a foolish oversight! If only I'd had your prescience and curiosity, I could have saved myself centuries of pondering that very question. Well, certainly he was not pleased with my insistence that we investigate. But the king's word is law. Was law. But the reason I was purged was slightly less intellectual. After the king refused to let me investigate the veil, I brought the issue up with others. The Seven Lords. Beneath the king in authority, but far above me. I brought them my research. I showed them everything. I had hoped they would help me convince the king of his error, but before they or I could act, I was arrested and... well... my sentence was carried out. I mean, yes, I suppose you could have drained the power from it, but that would have weakened it significantly. It would be quite irresponsible. After all, the power of the thing is not the point. It hid something. Who knows what that might have been? The secrets to the universe could have lain behind that curtain. But I was not given the chance to find out. Now, I fear I never will. He ceased to be my king the moment he turned on me. I did nothing wrong. All I wanted was to further the knowledge of the Eternals. Who knows? Had I been allowed to continue my studies, perhaps I could have warded off whatever catastrophe befell them. Given enough time, I could walk from this island to the shore, but time is in short supply. I must procure a quick way off this island, and that means procuring a ship. While there are certain unsightly bulges in your clothing, I doubt you are hiding an entire boat in there. It seems supporting the Seekers in their fight to take the Lady Vengeance is the path to follow.
The skeleton stands quietly for a moment.
I'm not sure. Centuries in a tomb can warp one's memory. I remember the big things, of course. My library, my home, my king, my family. But the rest, it's all covered in a fog. And the more I see of this world, the thicker that fog seems to get. Once I would have boasted that it was the best form of government. Indeed, it was the only form of government we knew. Living forever under the rule of a wise king is one thing, but if that king should turn into a despot, if he should reject philosophy and the natural arts for the sake of power, well, I cannot imagine a worse torture. I was a scholar, researching the secrets of the universe. Had I been allowed to proceed, my people could have ascended to godhood as one. an entire race of deities with a perfect understanding of the universe. It would have solved all of our problems. Indeed, you cannot. Nothing in this world compares to it. We crafted our homes from stone and crystal, using the power of the universe itself to keep them in place. Your people, on the other hand, seem quite content to sit about in smoky hovels held together by straw and filth. It's a mercy I don't have a nose. I cannot imagine how you stand it. They came rather low in my life, alas. My wife and daughter always had to compete with my work for my attention, and my work was always stiff competition. They were often neglected. I wonder how many more years they spent neglected before. Well, before whatever happened, happened. Well, of course it is. It was crafted with care. 100% ethically harvested from mortals, too. The quality is second to none. Oh, you simply wait until the creature is dead, preferably of natural causes. Although that does limit your choices somewhat, you may end up with quite a few sagging faces. I will never understand why you have so readily accepted aging or digestion. They are frightful pastimes. Up to a point, certainly. They are frightfully loud, but the selection afterwards is quite good. The faces are often what you might call fixer-uppers, but they're young and quite serviceable, if you get them before the flies do. Poison is preferred, of course. No marks to the face, the subject can be of any age, and death is often quite peaceful. Not for them, of course, but it's significantly more relaxing for me.
Are you certain you want to dismiss your companion?
Yes, I can imagine it might be somewhat difficult for you to forever be in my shadow. Go on then, play in the sun. I have actual work to do.
Let's team up, you and me. What do you say? Now, onward!